Hello guys, so in this video lesson I'm going to teach you the pressure prism principle. Pressure prism principle. So in this pressure prism principle, so now I'm going to sketch a tank, right? So now this tank, and this is the width of the tank. This is the width of the tank. Now this tank is filled with two liquids. So the first liquid is oil. Now oil is filled for a particular height of h1. Now this is the oil height. In this tank, oil is filled for a height of h1. Then water is filled for a height of h2, and this is filled with water. And h1 plus h2 is the total height, and this is the total height of the tank, which is h1 plus h2. So now by using this pressure prism principle, we are going to find the total force induced on this side wall. If you consider this particular tank, now this tank is filled with two liquids, as you know. So now we are going to find the total force exerted on this side wall. For that we are going to use the pressure prism principle, right? So we are not directly going to use prism, so we have to generate the prism. So let's see how to generate the prism. So now this is the front view. What is this front view? If you look from the front, this is the front view. If you look from the front, this is how it will appear. So this level we have oil, okay, and this level we have water. So right, so now I am going to sketch this triangle. This triangle represents the pressure distribution because of oil. This triangle represents the pressure distribution because of oil. And then from here I am going to compute this rectangle. This length is equal to this length, which is height h2, and this length is equal to height h1. Okay, so now then I am going to compute this rectangle, and then I am going to sketch another triangle. This triangle, right, this triangle represents the pressure distribution of water, right? So basically now we have two triangles and one rectangle. So this smaller triangle is for the pressure distribution of oil. And now if you consider the 3D view, if we consider the tank, and if I extend this, right, so if I extend, so if I extend this triangle up to the width of the tank, what you will be getting? You will be getting a prism. So here also we have another triangle, right? So this triangle is for the water, this triangle is for the pressure distribution because of water. So this triangle, if I extend up to the width of the tank, so I'll be getting the pressure distribution because of water. This is for pressure distribution because of water, and this is the width, this is the tank width. And here we have a rectangle. So this rectangle represents the pressure distribution of this hatched fluid. I mean, this rectangle represents the pressure distribution of the fluid below this level, right? So below this level we have fluid. So this rectangle represents the pressure distribution of the fluid which is below this oil pressure level. So if I extend this rectangle, if I extend this rectangle, I'll be getting a cube. Okay, so now this rectangle, from this rectangle we can form this prism. From this triangle we can form this prism, and from this rectangle we can form this cube. Okay, now carefully listen. The total volume of this prism, because of the oil pressure distribution, if you find the volume of this, it will give you the total force that is acting on the side wall because of oil, right? So this is volume V1. Then the total volume of this prism, which is generated because of this water pressure distribution, is equal to the total pressure that is generated because of water pressure distribution. And if you find the volume of this cube is equal to the total force that is generated because of this pressure distribution below this line. Understand? So now we have three different shapes. Now we need to find the volume of this. right? So now I'm again going to sketch it. This is the front view, this is the oil level, and this is the water level, this is the oil level, and this is the water level, and this is the height h1, and this is the height h2. Okay, and this is for the pressure distribution of oil. Then this triangle is for the pressure distribution below this level, and this triangle is for pressure distribution of water. So now this is shape 1, this is shape number 2, this is shape number 3. Okay, so now total force that is generated because of oil pressure distribution. So F1 is equal to the total force because of, or you can say due to, oil pressure distribution. Okay, so like that, what is F2? That is the total force due to, you can say, water pressure distribution. Okay, so like that, you can say what is F3 is equal to the total force due to pressure distribution, pressure distribution of region 3. Actually, now this is the region 3, right? And this is caused by, actually this region 3 is caused because of the pressure at this level, because pressure at this level, this oil pressure. So what is this oil pressure? What is this oil pressure? Actually, this line indicates a pressure. So this pressure is equal to H1, which is this height, because this height is H1, H1 rho oil G. Okay, so H1 rho oil G is the pressure at this level. Okay, so this rectangle represents the pressure distribution of the fluid below this line. Okay, so simply this rectangle represents the pressure distribution of the fluid below this line. So if you get, so if you want to find the total force under this rectangle, is the volume of that cube. Okay, so now I told you, because of these three different shapes, you will be getting three different volumes. So what is F1? F1 is equal to the volume of that small prism. Okay, so F1 is equal to the volume of that small prism. I will show you that again. So now this is the triangle we sketched for the oil pressure distribution. So if you find this volume, it is equal to the total force because of oil pressure distribution. So F1 is equal to that volume. So that is equal to half into base into this height. So that is equal to half. This base is H1 rho oil G into this height H1, multiplied by, because you need to find the volume of the prism, so you need to find the volume of this prism, so multiply by this width, that is W. So in the similar way, you can find the pressure distribution for the water pressure distribution. For the water pressure distribution, we have this larger triangle, so you can just sketch it. So that is equal to area of this triangle into this width. So how do you calculate it? So half into base. What is this base? H2 rho water G. Half into base into, what is this height? This is H2. So what is H2? H2 is actually this height. Okay, that's this height into that width, right? And the same thing, now we need to find the volume of this region. What is this region volume? What is that region volume? Right, so this is that volume, right? So how do you find this volume? This volume is equal to this area into this length, right? This area into this length, or the width. Okay, so what is this length? So look at here, in this rectangle, this length is equal to this length. So this is the oil pressure at this level. So So what is F3? F3 is equal to volume 3. It is equal to this length. This length is the oil pressure, which is H1 rho oil G into this height. So this height is H2 multiplied by this width, right? So now you know the total force. Okay, now you know the total force. Now what is the total force? Total force is F1 plus F2 plus F3. That is the total force. Now, so without looking at, you must be able to write. Actually, now these three total forces are three different volumes. So now we are going to add those three different volumes. I will again summarize it, because even the small things, I will tell again and again, this is this smaller prism. What is this? This is the volume of this larger prism. So what is this? And this is the volume of this, it is the volume of this cube like thing. It is the volume of this cube. So total force is equal to, for F1, half into base H1 rho oil G into height H1 into the width. So width is equal to W. Plus, now this one, half into H2 rho water G into H2 into this width. And again plus, so now all these three addition marks come in the same line, so plus, okay, plus this area, what is that? So this length H1 rho oil G into this length H2 into the width. So that is the total force. So now you know the total force. So now our target is to find where the total force is actually acting. So now you need to find that. Okay, so that is also a simple thing. So now let's see how to find that. So now again I will sketch this tank. Okay, this is for oil, this is for water, this triangle for oil, this is the rectangle for the pressure distribution below that, this is for the pressure distribution of water, right? So the total force acting because of this triangle, okay, so total force acting because of this triangle is at a distance which is 2/3 of this length, right? So if this length is H1, 2/3 of this length is 2/3 H1, right? That means starting from this top at a length of 2/3 of the total length, you will be getting the point where the total force is acting. To that point we call it is a centroid. If you consider this triangle, actually centroid is 2/3 from this level. So if you consider this triangle at a height of 2/3 of this total height, you will be getting the centroid, or you will be getting the point where the total force on this triangle acts, right? So the same thing applies for here. The position where the total force acting, right, or we call it the pressure center, the position where the total force is acting, because now, as you know, because of the pressure, that pressure can generate a force, right? So the center of pressure is the point where the total pressure is actually acting, or the total force is actually acting. So if you consider this triangle, the position where the total force is acting is 2/3 from this length, because I told you this length is H2. So 2/3 of this length is somewhere here. So but now, in order to do the calculations, we are going to consider the distance to the center of pressure from the top surface. Okay, so for this triangle, the center of pressure CP2 is from this top surface to here, right? From here we have to measure the distance to the center of pressure for this triangle from the top surface, that is CP2, and this is CP1. And for here also we have to measure, distance to the center of pressure of this rectangle, that is also we have to measure from the top surface. Because if you consider this rectangle, the center of pressure is right at the halfway, which is H2 by 2. If you consider this rectangle, the point where the total pressure is acting is actually at a halfway. But if you consider from the top surface, we have to add this top amount also. So the position for that will be, it is somewhere like here. So this length, so what is this length? This length is equal to this total this length is equal to this total length in h1 plus h2 by 2. Okay, so now let's again have an idea about the center of pressure CP1, CP2 and CP3. Okay, right. So now what is CP1? Center of pressure, the place where the total force is acting on this triangle. So it is 2 by 3 h1 from the top surface, because this is the top surface. And for CP2, it is you have to add this height h1 plus 2/3 of h2. It is from here. And for CP3, it is here. For that, you have to add h1 plus h2 by 2 from the top surface. Okay. So now the next target is, now the next target is to find the position where, if you consider the entire wall force, I mean, now in this tank we calculated the individual pressure, sorry, we calculated the individual force, and right, so we know the force because of this each pressure distribution, right, we know the force because of this each pressure distribution. So now we added it, so we know the total force on this sideboard. So now we know the total force on this sideboard, but now we want to find the position. Now we need to find the position where the total force is acting. Okay, for that we say center of pressure total. Okay, so center of pressure total, so center of pressure total is the position where the total force on the side wall is acting from the top. Okay, because the center of pressure, I mean that center point we measure from the, now our top surface is the reference, so this is our reference surface, right? So we find that location with reference to the top surface, is a reference surface. I mean, if you consider the all three different shape, position where the total force is acting measured from the reference surface, so that is CP2. So that's very easy. Now we have an equation, total force multiplying by the center of pressure of the total force, I mean the total force multiplied by distance to the position where the total force is acting, is equal to the individual force because of each element into the center of pressure of that element. It is equal to the multiplication of individual force because of that element into the center of pressure of that element, plus individual force because of the second element into the center of pressure of that element. You have to put brackets, and plus the total force because of individual element F3 into the center pressure of that element, right, the distance to the center pressure of that element CP3. So now this is the equation. So now position to the total position where the total force is acting CPT is equal to F1 CP1 plus F2 CP2 plus F3 CP3 divided by FT. So that's the